Next, we're going to talk about our basic needs. There are certain things that we and all living things need to have in order to survive. These things are referred to as our basic needs. And depending on who you talk to, they may have a bigger or shorter list. But in general, our basic needs, four of our basic needs, or I would say our main ones, are water, food, oxygen, and suitable living conditions. Water, I don't think I need to go into great detail about water, but us and our whole planet is all about water. Our planet is mostly water. Our bodies are mostly made up of water, 70-some percent water. If we don't have water, we die. And other living things, they need water in order to survive as well. Even those things that can survive in very dry areas, they still need a certain amount of water. There are certain types of organisms that, if there isn't enough water to survive, they go into a dormant state, actually. And actually, I shouldn't bring that up. I won't go into too much detail there. But it's just an adaptation that allows them to survive until there is enough water available. Number two, the second one would be food. Whether you're a plant or an animal, whether you're making your own food or whether you're a consumer and eat other things for food, we need it. That food is the energy and the nutrients, kind of the same thing that our bodies need in order to do what we do, in order to move, in order to grow, in order to repair ourselves, in order to reproduce. Food is energy. Okay. Now, oxygen, a third one, oxygen or air, allows our body to access the energy from the food that we've eaten, or if you're a plant, and from the food that we've made, that you've made. This is a process called cellular respiration. But all things need oxygen. Even if it's an organism that uses other gases as well, we need oxygen. All things need oxygen in their cells in order to process and access the energy that we've attained. Number four is suitable living conditions. This can be related to our climate. Could be like actually finding shelter. For us, it's building a home. For animals, it's finding a burrow or a den or shrubs to hide in or what have you. Some other things that are like living conditions but are not like a house, but they still protect us from the elements, are things like clothing. For us, we don't just go out naked, thank goodness, but we put on clothes, and that helps us to manage the temperatures that we happen to be in properly. For other animals, they grow fur, or if some organisms, aquatic organisms, they have blubber to deal with the low temperatures. Some animals will be active in the day, diurnal, and some will be active in the night. That's nocturnal, and that's in order to provide them with the living conditions that they need, or shelter.